And in this dream, I saw a dark black cloud over Britain. I saw it over Britain and over Europe. And it was as if I was looking down, as if I was sitting in the heavens, watching over Britain. And I heard the Lord say, I've got a plan. I've got a plan. And I saw light, just these, it's as if lightning started from the ground going up into heaven. And as this light broke through these dark black cloud, it was prayer. It was prayer that was arising in Britain, and it was a lot of houses of prayer. And in this dream, suddenly, it's as if I'm in the heavens looking down, but suddenly I was on the earth, looking at the earth, and I was looking in people's windows, and it was just like three or four people in their houses praying. And Jesus was standing right beside me, and he said, this is my house of prayer. It's gonna penetrate Britain. And in the dream, I saw that these three and four people that were gathering in their houses, some in their dining rooms, some in their living rooms, it wasn't 40 and 50, it was three or four. And these three and four people were making a difference on the earth. Their prayers were going forth as arrows. Their prayers were going forth, penetrating this black cloud that was trying to take over Britain, England, Europe. And in the dream, I heard a declaration, and it was just written upon my heart. And he said, there's a young royal who has made the newspapers from nation to nation. And in the dream, he said, I'm going to take his wildness, and I'm going to turn it to me in one breath. And he said, I will encounter him who is the second born of his father, he who is red and ruddy, and I will turn his heart to me in one breath. And he said, and he will walk alongside his brother as Nathan the prophet walked alongside King David. You call him Harry, but I call him Jacob. And he will lift up a cry for righteousness in Britain, and I'll use him as a voice. He'll lift up a cry of Jacob in Britain. And it's as if I saw in the dream, the scene changed, and suddenly I saw the leader of the land walk up the steps of Allah and pledge their allegiance to a foreign god on behalf of fame and favor and finance. And they said very mockingly, my leadership is inevitable. Nothing will ever stop it. And suddenly I saw this big hand come out of heaven, and on their papers in big red bold print, it said, rejected. And I'm watching this. It's as if I'm watching this happen on the earth. I'm watching God begin to stir people for Britain to pray. And he said, my eyes are on one like David. And my eyes are on one like Jacob. And I knew he was talking about the young princes, that he was marking them, and he was inviting us to pray. And he said, my eyes are on one like David. My eyes are on one like Jacob. And together they will lift up a cry for righteousness in the land. And I saw, suddenly the dream shifted and there were fires that began to break out all over Britain. And, you know, into Wales and into Scotland, all over the United Kingdom. And he said, I will take the United Kingdom and I will make it a kingdom that's united.
Peace,
I will
Lord.
Take the United Kingdom and I will make it a kingdom that's united.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
And in the dream, I saw fires just break out in the natural. Fires break out in the spiritual, which was prayer. And he said, I'm stirring the nations to pray. And one of those was France. He was stirring up prayer in France. And he was saying, it's not too late. It is not too late for Britain. It is not too late for Europe. It is not too late for the United Kingdom. It's not too late. I've got a plan. I've got a plan that's going to penetrate this cloud of black darkness. And this plan is when three or four people gather together and pray, you will penetrate that black cloud. Because God is going to have his way in every single way. And he's inviting the nations of the earth, and he's inviting Europe, and he's inviting the United Kingdom to pray and ask for God to break in mighty ways. He's inviting us to pray for the princes, because they're marked for God. Their encounter is soon. They're marked to be a voice for Jesus, to be a voice for righteousness. For the Lord said, I will encounter him who is red and ruddy, the second born of his father, and he will walk alongside his brother. As Nathan the prophet walked alongside King David, you call him Harry, but I call him Jacob. And he'll lift up a cry for righteousness in the earth. And I'll give you a sign. And in the dream, I saw like all of the papers, like the USA Today and all the important papers all throughout the nations. And they were actually making fun of this young royal. And the headlines were Jesus Freak. It was Harry found Jesus. It was lost found. It was all these headlines that were actually making fun of this young royal. And in the dream, the Lord said, when you see these headlines, it's going to be real. It's not going to be a joke. And it's going to stick. Because he is destined to be a voice. Because I've got a plan for Britain. I've got a plan for Europe. Don't rule out Europe. I got a plan. And this plan, it's not just the masses. It's not just calling a mass million person prayer meeting. I'm going to change the nations with three and four people gathering at a time. This is my house of prayer. This is where light will penetrate great darkness. And he's telling us his plan so that we can pray, so that we can lift our voice for the princes. Because in the dream I saw, it's as if I was in the heavens with Jesus, but I was also on the earth watching. I could see from both sides. And I was, as I was in the heavens, I saw their mother, the late Princess Diana. I saw her praying, even in the heavens, for her young sons. And I saw her praying for the nation that she loves. God has a plan that cannot be stopped. And he's inviting us to lift our voice, to not rule without any nation. I feel like even now the Lord says, don't rule out any nation. Don't rule out any nation. But it's an invitation to pray. And to everyone watching, for the viewers in Europe, in France, he's doing the same thing in France, where people are beginning to lift their voice and cry out for a revival, for an awakening. It's going to happen, France. It's going to happen. But he's inviting us to pray for the nations, to pray for Britain, to pray for the United Kingdom, to pray for Europe, because a natural sign will be when the fires begin to break out. The natural speaks of the spiritual, and there's real fires that's going to begin to break out as a sign that people are beginning to pray. The small prayers are going to change the atmosphere of the nations. And in the name of Jesus, I just pray, oh Lord, would you stir your people to pray? I ask that you would do this, God. I ask, God, that you would take the women. A lot of the women, I see a lot of women just gathering, two and three at a time, to pray for their nation. And I ask, Jesus, that you would gather the women, that you would gather your intercessors, and that you would help them, that you would stir them. You would stir them up with your zeal, God, to cry out for your way, that there is a day and there is an hour of a mighty breaking in, of the mighty fire of God breaking in and breaking out in the United Kingdom and in Europe. And I saw fire starting all over Wales and Scotland and Britain and Ireland. And God is going to have his way. Lord, stir up your intercessors right now. We ask for hope. We ask for hope for your thoughts. And we ask that you would give to Europe. We ask that you would give to the United Kingdom the spirit of wisdom and revelation, those mighty torches that are around your throne. Send them out, God, and cause your intercessors, your moms, the soccer moms, cause them to pray for your will, for a mighty breaking in over Europe. And we pray this in Jesus' name, and we thank you, and we pray, encounter the princes. Encounter Harry. Encounter William. Encounter them. Turn their hearts in one breath.
Watching ISN, the